No, this is going to be a Jade Druid. And we're going to lose. I hard mulligan for the axe. Just in case this is aggro druid. Let's see if we can find an axe here. I would be still found tools to deal with an aggro druid. But I haven't seen any aggro druids lately. They have all been Jade Druids. So I expect this one to be a Jade Druid as well. And then I would actually need some minions to pressure him with. C'Thun's Chosen, preferably. It's Jade Druid. Too bad. Once again, one more win to rank 5 and we're not going to get that one. Well, maybe if he doesn't find any ramp. That's ramp. Already feeling it. Wait, you should be Tenet, you forgot to win against Mage. Did I? Maybe I did. We can check the stats later. But the sad part here is that this is Jade Druid. Let's try to top deck something. It's not a bad Acolyte. I'll play that Acolyte together with the Whirlwind next turn. It will kill both of these minions and it will draw me an extra card. Say what, Guardian? Yeah, always Jade Druid. So there have been... Most of the losses have been to Jade Druid and Quest Rogue. Both are quite common on the ladder right now. So I have to say that I cannot recommend for you to play this deck. Sad as it is. It's simply something I cannot recommend. Because these matchups are pretty bad. He already found Ramp, he already found Nourish. Like, what else does he even want? I guess Auctioneer and the Innervate and Wrath. To draw? To kill? I'm surprised. I am a little bit surprised. Do I use Sleep with the Fishes on this one? I think I do. Sleep with the Fishes could kill up to 4/4 Jades. The only Jade so far is a 1/1. But what are my alternatives? There aren't any really good ones. Using a shield slam. Nah, it has to be Sleep with the Fishes. Let's kill that Auctioneer anyway. Killing the Auctioneer is pretty important. He got 2 draws off of that. But he did get rid of Sleep with the Fishes. I call it even. I need one more C'Thun buff to activate these fellows. But how do you even win from here? He has tons of resources, he has had ramp. I haven't been able to deal any damage yet. I mean, I need to start applying pressure, but that just seems impossible right now. Make a couple of jades. And I do not find what I need. I just don't. You start healing jade after jade on board. Yeah, Berserking, absolutely. This is not going well. I needed one more activator. Again, I have found one activator in the first 13 cards. There are 4 left in the deck. 5 if you count Doomcaller, but I'm not counting that usually. But I haven't found that one either. So 1 in 13 and there are 4 in those 17. This is the same thing that happened to me a couple of times already. Doesn't seem to be any good way to do this. I guess I'll go with something like this. I can't get armor. I could have coined up Shield Bear, but he challenges that on board. I mean, now he has to at least use a spell, and he already used a Wrath. So maybe he doesn't have that swipe. Swipe hero power, retain season die board. I already used the sleep with the fishes. Time to use the new brawl skill. Yeah, wizard, if he commits more on the board, then probably next turn. Next turn I might have to use it. But this just seems... I mean, I have to say that in these Jade Druid matchups I have drawn extremely badly. So that's also one factor. Seriously? He wants to go on the offense? Oh, that is weird. That's my activator. So I'll sacrifice this fellow here. 7, 8, 9 damage. And this guy can just go face. No need for it to trade anything. Let's play the Beckoner. Just armor up a little. Now I have a lot more armor coming. He has small minions on the board that can win the brawl so that his big minions die. Or maybe I'll just pump down some twin emperors and roll from there. Primordial Drake could come down. But yeah, 8 losses and there's 3 Questrogues, 2 Jade Druids so far. So more than half of my losses are to these two decks. But these two decks also seem to be too prevalent in the meta right now for me. Both of them at over 10% representation. Some more Jades. Alright. Too bad I don't have any whirlwinds effects left. Really too bad. Is there a reason for me to brawl this board? Well, he does have a pretty good trade into the Twin Emperors. I guess I can be a little bit more greedy with the brawl. Let's just play the Emperors here. I should be safe behind the Emperors. He doesn't have a ton of cards in hand. So if he commits some additional resources... That's an Earthen Scales. To enable a better trade. Alright, then what? There's no lethal, I can guarantee that. Not with Feral Rages, not with Swipes. Took him this long to decide that he wants to draw a card. Yeah, you kind of do want to draw a card here. Get small Jades down. Also goes in with the Swipe. Very aggressive. Very aggressive from him. Okay, then I guess I have to go in with the Shield Bearer. Alternatively, I might just brawl this board. What if I brawl? If anything else wins but the 6-6, I can kill it with the Shield Slam. Let's just brawl here. I think brawl here is fine. Because he's so low on cards. What? 6-6 won. No. Well, then I cannot shield slam it. Feels bad, man. I'm at 12. There is no way for him to kill me here, right? He needs 6 more. Swipe and Feral Rage is lethal. I guess I will coin the hero power. Because Swipe Earthen Scales Hero. Swipe Earthen Scales Hero power would also have been lethal. But now he needs Swipe and Feral Rage. And with those he could have lethal. Because I lost the 75% brawl. Man! The ability to lose a 75% brawl. That's quite something. My new brawl skill, I don't know what happened to it. It was such a good skill to have. It was such a good skill to have. Now it's gone. I can deal with one more Jade Golem, because I can Shield Bearer and double Shield Slam if I need to. Now I'll Shield Slam to 6-6. Alright. So I guess he was out of Jades there. Otherwise he would have just played something on the board. What can he have in his hand that he doesn't want to play? He could have Auctioneer, but no cheap spells. I don't even know what he can have there. More Jades, but I don't care. Alright, let's do this. We are going to do this. He is low on resources. We are so going to do this. More armor, more Shield Slam, more hitting phase. Let's go. Two executes, but nothing to activate them with. That sucks a little bit. C'Thun is just a 10-10. Another Jade? And? Nothing more. Well, that Jade can only kill one of these. So these guys are just still going face. Oh, Whirlwind. I guess I'll Shield Block first. Ooh, Disciple is even better. Now we Disciple here, and we execute this Jade. And we hit face again. Alright. Let's see about this. Now it's a 12-12 C'Thun. So this is actually a lethal setup now. I wonder what can he possibly have in his hand that he doesn't want to play. That's just something I do not understand. Double Feral Rage. Okay, well that does keep him alive. C'Thun cannot kill him through double Feral Rage. Then the question becomes, do I just play C'Thun here? He's not going to have hard removal in that deck. Is it 23? I could push another 12 damage. Yeah, absolutely. I'll push another 12 to face. So now he's at 11. And now things are getting interesting. Oh dear. Yogg. Okay, well, Yogg is definitely something he could have in his hand. No, brawl. He can win this with the Yogg. But he loses, right? No, he can still win. C'Thun doesn't kill him. It's one off. But he concedes. We win against the Jade Druid. Finally. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel for more.